You don't know, today we're playing some Planet Nomads. Now this game is brand new, it's in closed alpha, it's not actually technically out yet. It came out, I think it was released yesterday, I'm not too sure. Might have been the day before, I don't know. All I know is that I watched some videos on YouTube of it and thought, damn, I really wish I'd managed to get into the alpha to this. And then checked my email and discovered that yesterday, I think it was, I got the email for it. So yeah, I've lost a day on it, but hey ho. So this game is in closed alpha. That does mean that everything you see is likely to change. It's going to be buggy. It's going to have problems to it. But well, let's just grab into it and see how it goes. Hello World. That seems like a good name for a game. Oh, click one button, generate a world. If only it was that easy. And here we are. We're in the world. We are, I don't know where. I do know there are, I think, 9 different biomes on this world. It's not got everything with it yet. All you can build are buggies and cars and things, but you can't build anything flying yet. You can't go out and crash into the sun or visit other planets or anything. That's not in the alpha yet. This is just purely a creative mode testing game to see what happens. I do know if we zoom out, we have a jetpack. We can hold space and jetpack. It's standard WSD keys. It's just standard sort of game. Very similar to Scrap Mechanic or Space Engineers, but I've not played Space Engineers, so I can't really compare the two. I'm guessing Scrap Mechanic because of this. The wonderful little jack. That's how Scrap Mechanic does stuff. It's got press F1 for tutorial. Ah, there's the controls. Flashlight, space to jump, holster is H, right. Building. Scroll the mouse roll to rotate X. Oh, right, standard build vision. Yes, that's an interesting thing to go. And they show you how to build a little buggy here. So I think that's what we should do. We should start off building a little buggy and driving around. From what I've seen of the videos to it, the dev videos, if you travel north, which is that way, you end up in the cold, and if you travel south, you end up at the equator. Which is a bit weird considering south I can see snow. So I'm guessing I'm pretty far north on the planet at the moment. Anyway, let's build a little buggy thing. We've got our items here. B brings up the build menu. There's loads of different blocks here. 50 something different blocks. Interior blocks, exterior ones. You can build all sorts of weird stuff. But to start with, I'm going to build the tiny little buggy. So start off with that. So I used to use the mouse wheel to scroll through the action bar at the bottom. Too much Minecraft, I think. Let's stick down. Ooh, stick down that, and there's our cockpit. Now four. Let's make some wheels, shall we? You can see you've got the little green line there. You can see that if I press X, it changes the axis. So now when I scroll the mouse wheel, it rolls around that axis or that one. Or that one. It's very, very easy controls. Very simple. Easy to play, easy to use. And I like that. I like simple. Simple is good. Click to put blocks. You can't actually drag something. Something I could do with, I think. As I said, I did watch a few videos of this before I realised I even owned the game. Captain Shack was the main one. I watched his stream of it, and he's obviously gone through and showed everything for it, and probably does a better job than I do, but I'm here just to get things wrong. That's what I generally do. Now, slap my wheels on. Like that. I can hear lots of wind. There are environmental effects. We've got rain and snow and everything else generally. Six, we need to put on a little jump with a jetpack. Oh yeah, if you look down you can actually see you. that's something very unique to games. Most of the time it's like, I'm just a head floating in the nothingness. Yeah. So, right, now, we've got our energy thing over there. And, well, the sun's going down or it's just getting cloudy. But the wonderful thing about him, you press tab to bring up the build menu and you get this. You get an I think the chat called it an augmented reality. Fantastic. Essentially, every item you look at that you place down that has the option is just accessible via looking straight at them, rather than going through a control panel or menus or anything. So for instance, that is facing the wrong way. So we can change the direction of the wheels to go that way, like that. Ah. And also, I can steering on the front too, because that's what we want. I want to be able to actually steer this little buggy. Shift to run, yay. And also, the energy system in this. In scrap mechanics, you've got to use a, not a welder, there's a tool for it where you have to link things together. With this one, it is literally mouse over your energy or your battery and go connect. Connect. Job done. I love that. That is fantastic. Very easy, very simple to do. It is getting dark. The sun is setting. I've started in the afternoon. Isn't that great? Bring the flashlight out. The lighting's fantastic as well. Look, lights up everything. And you know, speaking of which, let's put some. What do we got here? Front mounted or top mounted? I'm going to go with top mounted. Drag them out to the action bar. Press tab to turn off the build menu. Do-do-do. You can no doubt once again hear me slapping the keyboard. I need to sort something out with that. I can't put them there. I'll put them on the side. There we are. There's our lights. Go back into the tab menu and link them to our power source. Ba-dum. Ba-dum. There we are. Aha. And that's it. That's a working buggy. A complete little working drivable buggy. So the lights are running. There's an awesome moon rising there. Look at that. Look at that. This game is very pretty. Constellations in the sky. And the sunsets. Yes, this is fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. So, now we right click, take that out. There we are. We've got a buggy. We can push E to get into it. It's got loads of little powers down here that aren't actually doing anything. Weird light in there. They're just for show, really. But you can drive around. You can EB and drive around. Awesome. So I'm going to go. I'm going to go north, I think. It's getting extremely dark. Extremely dark. I wonder if I can. Nope, there's no lighting option, so when it gets dark, it gets really dark. Now, if you turn on build vision whilst you're in a vehicle, you can crash into things because you're not paying attention. You can see the little lines, see the green lines? That means that my generator is powering my wheels. If they turn orange, it means you've not got enough power to do what you're doing. So, well, you'd obviously need bigger generator, better batteries, or something like that. Turn that off again. Oh, I smashed the bush to pieces. Oh, I'm sorry, bush. I'm also stuck. I'm stuck. I am completely stuck on a bush. Maybe I should have made this four-wheel drive. Carry on going north. Very, very, very pretty looking. There's the bushes. I must remember, you can't just drive. I'm so used to games where trees are solid and bushes are not. Bushes are just, you know, your standard sort of 2D things that turn around as you walk towards them. But let's carry on. It is very dark. I'm having difficulty seeing, so I dread to think what it's like for you watching this. I'm Sorry about that, but unfortunately I can't do anything about it right now. I don't have the power to control the sun. If I did, that would be quite useful, I'm sure. So I can make solar energy a lot more effective, but well, we're definitely somewhere a bit colder. If I turn my flashlight on whilst I'm in here, I can actually look around and see things out there with my flashlight. If I come to a stop, you can see if I look around, my flashlight just shines out the window and I think it's raining. It's raining, yay. But let's go on an adventure. Let's just drive into the poles, not the sunset. Very rainy. Oh, look at this. It's June Buggy Simulator 2016. It's all some fun so far. There isn't obviously a lot to actually do in the game. It's only got creative mode. There's no survival yet. That will come along later. You have to mine for resources and get things, and there'll be space and loads of other things, I'm sure. Absolute loads of things coming along. However, this is... I was looking for somewhere quite large and flat. Try and build something. I can see lots of trees in the distance, but I don't know if there's an actual forest or whether it's just... And here looks pretty good. I could build a small building here. See how that works. Yeah, let's do that. Let's press E to get out. There we are. Little buggy there. And if you go into the build menu, you can... you've got a full block, and you've got 3x3 blocks. The difference between the two is quite literally, it's 4 blocks, and your 3x3 is just that. It's 3x3. They can attach between the two, so you can mix and match them, which is, from what I understand, something you can't do in Space Engineers. You can't mix large blocks and small blocks. I don't know. I've not played Space Engineers. Don't really know if I'm missing out or not. I'm not sure. But right, let's get rid of these things here. Down there. And let's have a look, see what we've got here. Slopes and ramps. Corner arc windows and things and floors. Floor is a good place to start. Hinges as well. Windmills or similar spinning constructions. Oh, that looks like fun. That's build a windmill. Yeah, let's build a windmill. Let's go for that, shall we? That's my floor, apparently. Ah, there we are. Floor was under the ground. So let's point to south and put them. There's no click and drag to build things. That's one thing I would like, I think. One thing I'd like to see is the ability to just hold and drag it out so it sort of draws a line. Again, early alpha, so, you know, I can forgive a lot of things. A lot of things will be added to the game. Many things will change, no doubt. Very easy to build. Very, very Lego-y. I like that. I like. Who doesn't like Lego? Lego is awesome fun. Let's. Getting lots of wind again. The night sky there. Moon does look fun. We need to go there. We need to go to the moon. But my buggy won't get there, so. Oh. Right. So. See here, let's build a tower. Let's build a tiny little tower in one corner. Let's do that. Up we go. Oh, bit weird looking down actually seeing yourself. That's nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with it at all. I don't mind seeing the character. That's absolutely fine. Just is a little bit weird. That's all. That's just not something I'm used to in any way, shape or form. Get on that platform. There we are. Right. Now, I think as well. Yes, of course. Everything is physics based. So, I think. I'm not actually sure whether you can just take away. No. A 3x3 block is a 3x3 block. I did think it was just a 3x3, and then I could use the little one cube to sort of take away one bit. But nope, it doesn't work that way. So, yes. But there are physics in this. If I was to build out like that and then break that block, but they fall down. So, I'm not quite sure how actual physics-y it is. I don't know. What does that do? Oh, yep, that falls over. So, yep, there's no block damage at the moment. Roll the dice, that part. No block damage at the moment, so. Right. Ooh, let's go up here again. And, do that. Run out of energy. The bottom left corner, you can see that, not a hexagon. This is a hexagon. Six-sided. Yes, it's a hexagon. But yeah, right on the outside, that's my jetpack fuel. Inside, I've got my health, obviously, 100%. And I've got energy, food and water, I think. Or, I'm not sure what the actual powers are, but I'm creative mode, so I can't die. I don't think I can die. I keep scrolling the world to change this. I don't think I can die. Not 100% sure on that. I don't know whether that's a good thing or but it's obviously a good thing that I can't die. That's a good thing. And up we go. There we are. Right. Now, can I use the crouch? Aha! I'm not quite sure what I'm doing here with this. I'm not sure why I've come up so far, to be honest with you. I could have we've done this further down. Bonked on the head, I think, there. Raining again! The rain. Very dark as well. Now, putting down lights isn't just as easy as literally sticking a light down. It doesn't work that way. If I were to put down a light, say, there, it doesn't do anything. It won't actually work because it needs energy. Everything needs some form of energy. Bring shadow then. So in order to do that, I would need to go back down here, boom, put down my energy block, and then in my build mode, build vision, yep, that's the one, I'd have to go up and completely missed the platform. And connect, and it works. Everything has a purpose. Everything has a reason. It's all got to link together. It's all got to be, it's snowing now. It's snowing, and the sun is rising, so we can continue off on our little journey, which I shall do. Ooh, it's getting bright. I just wanted to build a windmill. Doing. Yeah, we've got a windmill. Put that away. I have absolutely no idea what use that is. I don't know. Can it be linked to anything? No, it's not got any any abilities or anything at the moment, so presumably that will be for power generation. You might be able to build a windmill of some description. A gun. What's a drill? Oh, that's the drill, yes. But yeah, I assume that would be for the later on, for spin it round, for building a windmill. So yeah, right, let's continue our epic adventure to the North Pole. I've got no map, there is no actual map here. Before we go anywhere, actually, there is one thing I do want to check out. In the here there is something called a beacon. It's huge, absolutely huge. Look, so I'll plonk that down there, shoot, and then link it to that. There we are. We have a particle cannon into the sky. We are going to bring down all the comets and stuff. It's a beacon. It's to tell me where this place is, in case everyone come back. I don't know. I may do. I may not. I'm not sure. All I know is I'm going to continue north, which was that way. Ooh. And it looks like there's some rocky mountain over there. We need some wings on this. Gotta say, for an early access game, essentially, for an early alpha, the first release they're actually being to put out to anyone, it's playing very, very well. It's a bit jumpy at the moment as I'm moving at high speed, but that would make sense because it's loading a lot of stuff to do with it. But actual gameplay wise, it's very, very smooth. I don't feel like there's anything desperately wrong. Whoa, spinning around. Anything that's desperately wrong with it? And Captain Shack had issues with the wheels being a bit derpy, but I've not got that issue yet. I don't know whether it was the way he was building or not. Maybe? I don't know. I am now stuck, however. Should have made this four-wheel drive. There are strange green trees, which I don't think you can chop them down yet. I'm not sure on that. It does slide a lot. There's not much traction on wheels at the moment. It does seem to slide an awful lot. A forest here, look. Lots of trees. Oh, and solid bushes again. I really have to remember those. I'm stuck. I am actually stuck this time. We're actually completely stuck. My rear wheels are off the ground. So, let's make this a four-wheel drive. Connect the front wheels to the power grid. That's the way to do it. And then go. Oh, see, it's turning yellow now. They're turning yellow as I'm going, and my lights are dimming. That's a dead far sure way to know that it's not working properly. So, more boosters. More engines, that's what it is. More battery packs, that's the one I was after. Link this new one to the rear wheels. Oh. That was... the bush went crunch. Adding more weight. That seemed to work. Add more weight, the bush goes crunch. Awesome. Right, I'm going to disconnect this one from the rear. Just the front. The front engine, or the front battery pack, the forward battery pack does the forward wheels, the rear battery pack does the rear wheels, and the front one also does the lights. So, yeah. Let's do this again, and let's see. Oh, the front one's not quite getting as much power as the rear ones. But that's okay. That's alright. We've got a slippy slidey rear wheel drive here. Right, okay, so how do we balance that then? How do we go about doing that? What's... but these are set to slow speed. Wow. I'm quite impressed with that. They're set to slow speed. I'm thoroughly impressed with that. So if I connect these to the front as well, this rear one, we've then got two batteries on all of them, and four on the front. Oh, will that work? Dim a little. Not sure if the sun's gone down again already, or it's just because it's raining. It's getting dark again. But obviously, different biome. Oh, that was a solid plant. Oh dear. Right, little mini plants. They hurt. Don't hit them. I'm also not sure if this buggy's sliding around because it's wet. There might be environmental effects. I'm not sure. I don't really know. Ooh, that could be interesting. It does seem to be slippy slidey. Now I've added an extra engines, it seems to be slippy slidey. Oh, and we're crashing. No block damage, luckily. Otherwise, well, my buggy would be in several pieces at the moment. Aha. Can of course knock things over by smashing into them. Right. Get me bearings. Let's go round. This is obviously another biome. Got green, red grass. Got green grass back there. Red grass here. And these weird green trees. Can I mine the trees? What's that? I'm definitely sliding. Definitely sliding. Doing a couple of drifting things. That's quite interesting. Mind a tree. I'm guessing no. Nope, can't mind a tree yet. Okay, fair enough. The sun stopped. The rain stopped. The sun's come out again. So let's slip and slide over again. Yeah, the wheels need a little bit more traction, I think. Need somewhere to change. Every time I accelerate, I'm just pulling to one direction. I'm going to change it up again. I'm going to change it back up again. Easier doing first person mode. Let's disconnect these front wheels. No power to the front wheels. At all. I just reconnect them. Oops. And you disconnect from the front wheels. So we're just going back to rear wheel drive again. That's not really sure if that's better or not. But let's go with that. Let's continue on. Continue north. Without a map, I don't know if I'm going to get to North Pole, or even if I've just stopped myself through saying that because I've got a compass at the top of the screen. So I'm going to know when I hit the North Pole because north will become south. That's how actual, like, compasses work. They always point to the North Pole, so if I just carry on following the N, I'll eventually get there. There is a very large mountain over there, though. I want to go up that. That looks like it could be fun. Yeah, this whole episode is basically going to be me driving around in a buggy because it's fun. I'm enjoying this. I like this. The game runs, as I've said, very, very well. I'm thoroughly impressed with that. I need to do a bit more building to do with it, but the little bits that I've seen and the little bits that others have played and what I've done so far, being able to drag when you're holding blocks to build lines of stuff, that would be very nice. Even drag along two axes so you can build like a platform, that would be fantastic. I know they put a lot of effort into the wheels. I think I'm getting better traction up here, mainly because I'm driving slower. It could have just been the fact that it was wet. I think. I'm thinking, or maybe I'm even driving. Maybe this is icy. I don't really know how to find out what biome I'm in. It looks icy, so it could literally be I'm just sliding around on the ice. That's what it could be. So I don't know. We're slipping in the forest a lot in the rain, so probably environmental. The wheels are probably fine, and I'm being picky. But hey ho. Right now we're definitely on the ice, and very slowly climbing. Yeah, that's there. Hooking the electric up. I like the idea that they've done with it. It's really good. Just going generator to light bulb or wheel or whichever. And I like just the wheels. The wheels are the engine. There's no build a separate engine and do that, which is what Scrap Mechanic did, I think. But then Scrap Mechanic had the whole engine connects directly to wheel. So it's the same sort of principle, I suppose. But rather than having an actual engine that you need to power and then do that, I like what they've done with it. Might get a little tedious if you're doing like 100 lights, interior lights, because you've got to go back to the box every time. Or maybe you don't. Maybe there's a shortcut to it that I just haven't noticed yet. I'm not sure. I don't know. I'm finding all these wonderful things. Monkey biomes and the moon's come up again, and it's definitely come nighttime. You can dig, it's voxel based as well. Let's jump out of the vehicle here, bring up my drill, trust drill. You can dig straight into the ground. It is voxel based, so you can turn the flashlight on. You can just dig straight into the ground and clip through the. Yeah, you clip through that, but that's a minor thing. Many games do that. You can clip through the floor in games that are 20 years old. So, you can just dig. So, if you wanted to build an underground base, you could. I'm stuck. Yeah, I've got a tunnel. You could dig an underground base if you wanted to dig out a large side of a mountain. That's probably how you're going to get the resources, I'm guessing. You drill. There's no way to refill at the moment. You'd have to put in flooring or something, I suppose. Put in platforms along. Or how well that would work. But yeah, it's... That's there. I think the drilling will come... When you've got to collect resources, I think that's when the drilling will really come into it. When you've got to dig through... Saw one of the development diaries, or trailers, I think it was, where there was a very large cave with... glowing green rocks in it, uranium or kryptonite or something, I don't know, but yeah, that's where the drill obviously comes into it. You'll drill in and gather your resources, and once you've got enough resources, you can then build yourself a buggy and go driving around the world, or build a plane, or build a spaceship, or I don't know if planes will be in it, probably not, I wouldn't think. Generally, if you've got spaceships, don't really go with planes. Hell Space Program is an exception to that, but I think most other games don't do the physics for planes. Wing lift and stuff, I suppose, is very... I'm not sure. Maybe you might be able to. I don't know, but... Yeah. Yes. So yeah, my first impression of Planet Nomads is I like it. I like it a lot. I think it's good. I like where it's going so far. For an early access, as I've said, this is very smooth. It's got a lot in it. I am going to carry on driving and try and get to the North Pole. That's what I'm going to do. And then I'm going to try and build something there. See maybe how high we can go. See if I can build a great big structure up to... If I could build to space. Probably not possible. But I like the idea behind it. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go to the North Pole. I'm going to find the North Pole, or close as I can to it. And then we'll start building. So, hopefully, I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this. It's not available to buy yet, I think. I'm not sure. I got an early access key. I don't know if you can still buy into it. Obviously, I backed the game, so... I got a key for it. I'm not 100% sure on that. If I figure that out, I'll leave a comment below. I'm not I'm not sure whether you can still actually get access to it or not. Probably still can do, but I'm not sure. But yeah, overall, this is good. This is. I like it. So yeah. I'll see you at the North Pole. Have fun.